spoke with me yesterday at night, the past night. And in that conversation, the Lord showed me that there's going to be a very, very big revival. It's going to be a massive revival from this level. And every nation that will hearken unto the voice of the Lord will partake of this revival. So this is a very powerful time in the history of the church. Again, I want to repeat what the Lord has spoken yesterday at night, coming to this day morning, the day that is ending East African time here. The Lord Jehovah, he showed me the humongous revival that is going to break out in this country here. And all the other nations that will follow this voice of the Lord, where there are people working, where there are servants of the Lord that are hearkened to the voice of the Holy Spirit and what is instructing the church to do now, repentance, the return to holiness, the return to righteousness. And so the Lord showed me that in the urban areas, I saw a lot of people coming from work. They were coming from work, rushing to Bible study. And there were these big Bible study places in people's homes, in some rooms, in churches and places. People were running with Bibles and notebooks, Bibles and notebooks. And the Lord took me there. I walked among them already. People were having notebooks and Bible studies were going on. And down in the villages too, I saw people meeting in homesteads, rushing with notebooks and Bibles. And Bible studies were being dispensed. The Holy Word, the message of repentance, the message of return to righteousness, the message of the return to holiness was being preached, the message of the coming of the Messiah, the message of the bride of Christ to prepare, preparedness, readiness, the bride to be ready, the message of the garment. So they were listening to what the two prophets of the Lord were commanding and instructing from the throne of God, and they were passing down, dispensing down, administering down to the rest of the sheep, the rest of the people in the churches, in the urban, in the villages. It was such a tremendous beauty to see. It was a powerful beauty to behold. And so for all the nations that will listen to this and pay attention to the voice of the Lord and not follow the heedlessness of their hearts, not follow the haughtiness, the haughtiness of men, not follow the pride of men you see in the other nations, so-called developed, whichever the nations are. This tremendous pride you are seeing among the pastors out there. But I'm saying for those that will humble and follow the instruction of the voice of the Lord at this hour, the voice that the Lord has raised now, instruct and prepare the nation, and prepare the church, the glorious coming of the Messiah. They will see tremendous exploits of revival. They will see the massive end-time revival. And the Lord has used Kenya as this classroom to teach, to project forth that revival that's going to spread out to many nations. And so he took me to the city of Nairobi. I saw a lot of people, beginning with a conference to take place in Nakuru. I saw a lot of people from other churches rushing with notebooks. And I saw people, I saw them across this land. I saw in the cities, in the towns, in the villages, everybody rushing for Bible study. So this is a very powerful time, beloved people. Let nobody be mistaken about this. That the Lord has released his voice. The Lord has spoken his instruction. The Lord has spoken. And the Lord has openly and publicly across the face of the earth unveiled his voice and his messengers. So whoever wants to listen, it is now clear they can listen. Everybody from Brazil, all the way to Argentina, to Europe, all the way to the United States and Australia, Africa, Asia, they can tune in and listen, even the islands. And this is the revival that is coming to the church, beloved people. So may the Lord bless you as you prepare for a massive revival, not just the wonders, the powerful miracles, but he's even raising the word another notch, a hunger in the hearts of people, rushing for Bible study. I see them driving in the cities very fast, for rushing on foot to get to their Bible study places, the altars of the Lord. They're running to the altars of Jehovah that they may hear the message of repentance, the message of the cross, the message of the blood, the message of repentance and turning away from sin, the cross, the blood, the message of return to righteousness, the return to holiness, the message of Jesus, the message of the coming of the Messiah, the message of preparedness, the garment of the Lord. May the Lord bless you beloved people, as we are preparing. It's a mighty, mighty time, and I know that this is going to be such an awesome moment in the history of the church. Shalom Tada, the Messiah is coming. Shalom Tada, Tada, Tada.